What is a programming paradigm? A programming paradigm refers to a style or method of writing a program. Let's assume you asked 10 people to create an omelette. They would each prepare it differently. Which of the following is the typical method for making an omelette? A similar issue will arise if you ask 10 persons to complete the identical program. They will each complete it in their way. So programming paradigms are different techniques for writing your program. It is critical to understand how we will write a program. Understanding the programming paradigm is necessary for that. When selecting a programming language for building a program or software, we must ensure that it supports the programming paradigms. Why do we need a programming paradigm? One of my favorite coding quotes is, "Any idiot can create code that a machine can understand. Skilled programmers produce code that humans can understand." Consider building software with 10,000 lines of code with a group of people. What happens if they all create the software in their style? First and foremost, the program's complexity will rise. The program's readability and structure will suffer. It will be tough to test, and updating the code will be incredibly complex. What will happen if everyone writes your application using a set standard? We can reduce many of the problems. A programming paradigm will assist us in resolving all problems. Thus, the programming paradigm offers a unique standard for developing programs or software. Types of programming paradigm. The two sorts of programming paradigms are imperative programming and declarative programming. The two types of imperative programming are procedural and object-oriented. There are two types of declarative programming, logical and functional. Let us examine each of these points in further depth. Imperative programming. The word imperative implies command. Imperative programming tells the computer how to complete a task by giving a list of commands or instructions in a specific order. The order of instructions is significant in imperative programming. In this example, we are giving the computer line-by-line instructions on how to add to numbers and subtract to numbers. Procedural programming. In procedural programming, we divide the problem into smaller subproblems. We often refer to this structured approach. A procedure is a chunk of code that performs a specified task. Data and logic are separate entities in procedural programming. Here we have two procedures, add to numbers and subtract to numbers. The main procedure will call this subprocedure to add and subtract numbers. Object-oriented programming. In object-oriented programming, we will use classes and objects to create an entire program. The whole program will run depending on object interactions. Objects are real-world entities with properties and behavior. The classes act as the object's blueprint. Classes describe the characteristics and behavior of objects. In this example, you can see that we have three classes, calculator, addition, and subtraction. The addition class is in charge of adding to numbers. The subtraction class is in charge of subtracting to integers. So the calculator class will call the addition and subtraction classes to add and subtract to numbers. Here, all three classes interact to produce a result. Declarative programming. In declarative programming, we tell the computer what to do rather than how to do it. We shall always focus on output or result in declarative programming. In this sample code, we are telling the database what we want rather than how it should do. Functional and logical programming are the two main subtypes. Functional programming. In functional programming, we will split the entire program into two functions. Each function takes some parameters as input and returns the output. JavaScript is one example of a functional program. Here in the example, we have three functions. The addOneNumber function adds two integers, the subtractOneNumber method subtracts two integers. So these two functions have two parameters like I, j. It returns the output. So the calculate function is responsible for adding and subtracting two numbers. Logic programming. Logic programming is composed of facts and causes rather than instruction. In logic programming, we will build an entire program based on the notation of logical detection. Logic programming uses its knowledge to arrive at a true or false conclusion. Example: Prolog language. In this example, we tell the computer, Socrates is a man, and we say, all men are mortal. Then we ask the computer, is Socrates mortal? The computer will then use its knowledge to reply yes. Conclusion. In the previous section, we learned how to write a program in different programming styles. The same program has rewritten it in different ways. For example, functional programming, we split the program into small functions. In a procedure, we divided the entire program into individual procedures. In object-oriented programming, the whole program is split into objects. So it is clear that using a programming paradigm reduces the complexity and increases the program's maintainability.